$1,000 in one shot. And, but anyway, I found out how to make that light. But you're finding out things all the time. Yes?
Sam, I know that some people will start out painting actually on the board or whatever,
right. Yeah.
In black and white.
They do?
And then they'll put something over it to keep it from bleeding through, and that's what that, then they'll go and put the color on top of that. That's their
that's
guide.
Right. That's
I've never done
do.
That.
Well, my wife used to
does that work?
Acrylic.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You do it acrylic.
Except that you're, instead of putting it down in black, put it down in a dark tone.
Uh-huh.
So you won't have to fight, you know, battle over black. But sure, you could do your whole painting in values.
Right. Yeah.
You know, just values.
That's what I have such terrible time with values. I just don't understand them at all.
Yeah, but you don't understand values?
No. I mean, I know intellectually I do, but when I get in the color pot, I think, purple, green, wow, and it's gone.
Okay, well then there's a light purple, and then the purple might get deeper.
Yeah.
So as it gets deeper, the value of that purple changes.
But would it be helpful to me to start off with a monotone painting and...
Well, you could have that alongside of you on another drawing. You know, I make countless drawings. You make another drawing and doing it in dark and light. And then when you do your first painting, put your darks, your dark colors where the dark is. And then, of course, if it's a gray, and when the gray is dark, it won't be as dark as a black. If a black horse, the dark part of a black horse will be darker than the dark part of a gray horse, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So if that's the case, then you think of it as the dark part of that gray horse is not as dark as the dark part of the black horse.
But is it, I know that Munnings used to do a lot of gray horses.
Yeah.
Don't the gray horses come forward always because they're lighter?
No, I think a lot of times they'll drop back. You can get on a gray horse, the contrasting light on the gray horse may not be as sharp as the contrasting light on a darker horse.
Mm-hmm.
See? You know what it is, Faye? It's experimenting and trying different things. And seeing that this thing is not working, and sometimes somebody could give you an idea of how to make it work. I might say something, like I've looked at other artists, and I'll suddenly come across something that had been bugging me for years, and here this guy has done it. And then all you gotta do is sit down and be patient and figure out how he did it, or what he did. And after a while, you'll work with more conviction. You won't just noodle. You know,
oh, great noodle.
Like, this is the thing I always admire about Munnings. I might noodle a tone until it's the right value. Munnings could put it right down. And that is always a thing that I admire. He doesn't fuss around with it. He'll say, that's whatever it is, and he puts it down with one slash of paper. And say, geez. And I admire that. Of course, now, a lot of the tendency is to be photographic and to noodle and get it so that it's so, you know, the painters, you don't see very many painters there. Yes?
You did that whole horse by starting with two ears.
Yeah.
Did you do that?
No, I, that's